comes alive like an angel. Falling from the sky, here comes the light. You can see it if you open up your eyes. Here comes the light. I won't let this take my whole life away.
Touring with Hinder was really fun. We had a really good time with those guys, and we were out about 6 weeks or so. The first half was kind of rough. The weather was awful. It was nothing but snow and ice in the Northeast. But we got to know those guys really well. I really enjoyed touring with them. They're really fun guys to hang out with. I felt like our personalities clicked really well. As well as Shaman's Harvest was on that half the tour. We really liked those guys a lot. A band called Revolve out of Baltimore. The second half was Sons of Texas, which if you haven't seen the Sons of Texas, do yourself a favor and look them up. And also Ages Apart joined us on the second half as well. But it was a good tour for us, and it worked out. You know, we're going to go do our record with Cody Hansen from Hinder. And we'll talk about that here a little bit later. One show that stands out for me for sure was actually the last night of the tour, which was in Sioux City, Iowa. It was Anthem at the Hard Rock Casino. It was a sold-out show, really cool room. Sioux City, for some reason, every time we play Sioux City, we have a fantastic crowd, and we have a great time. Hinder called everybody up on stage during Get Stoned at the very end of the show to kind of, you know, send off a finale farewell for the tour. That was something really special for us to be a part of. So, yeah, we're kind of doing everything independently. We're a true independent band. You know, we're raising our own money, putting out our own records, doing everything on our own. It's a pretty tough situation, but the way the industry is now, we feel like it's the right move to make. As far as having some other bands on the label, that may be something down the road that we entertain. But right now, the focus right now is on Within Reason and getting the record out, getting a single to radio and moving forward through 2016. Like I said earlier, there's lots of challenges being an independent band. I think the biggest challenge that we have is raising our own money to pay for our record, pay for our advertising, you know, pay for our merchandise. Because a record label kind of loans you that money up front, and we don't have somebody doing that. So we've got to go out and raise our own money, whether it be private investors or our own money out of our pocket, or we'll go play shows, take some of that money to pay off certain things. So definitely the financing of the band's career has been the hardest struggle we've had so far. We've had a lot of cool things in our career. The biggest highlight, I'm not even real sure. I would say our trip to the Grammys was pretty cool. That was a neat thing to experience. You know, we got to do the red carpet. We did a commercial for Microsoft. When the Surface tablet came out, you know, when that commercial debuted, launching the Surface tablet, it was us in the commercial. So that was kind of a really cool thing to kind of be in the highest echelon in the industry, even though we kind of felt like we stuck out a little bit, like we weren't really supposed to be there. But that was something that I felt like was really cool, and it was a good opportunity for us to network with a lot of people. A lot of things came out of that as far as some endorsement deals and some people working with us. So I think the trip to the Grammys in 2013 was probably one of the biggest highlights of the career, in my opinion. We were actually talking about putting together a tour this year. A couple of bands that we talked to that would be perfect for our band. Theory of a Dead Man was one. Three Doors Down was another. We feel like you got to kind of look at the fan bases and decide, you know, where can you be the most successful? You know, there's a lot of bands that I love and I'd love to play with, but it just doesn't totally make sense. Like Avenged Sevenfold, for example. I'd love to tour the Avenged Sevenfold, but it really doesn't make sense for a band like us. So I think Three Doors Down, Theory of a Dead Man, Hinder was a perfect fit for us. Seether was kind of a perfect fit for us. So that's what we're looking at now this summer, is hitting up some of those bands and see if we can get a run together. So we like to tour a lot. This year, 2016, I'd like to get 200 shows in this year, which is a ton of touring for any band at any level. The best aspects of it is it's great. Like, that's something that we love to do. We love to go out and play shows for the fans. We love to be on the road. We like to see the world with our friends. The only downside is you kind of miss your friends and family at home. But it makes it a little bittersweet when you get there. But to me, it's just so much fun to get out there and tour and be in a different city every night. And once you do it enough, you know, you start gaining friends in all these different cities. So it's fun to kind of catch up. It's almost like you get a reunion every night with old friends that you haven't seen since last year. 2016 is going to be a good year for Within Reason. We are about to begin recording a brand new record. We're going to do it with Cody Hansen, who was the drummer for Hinder. Him and Marshall Dunton, their singers, they have a studio in Oklahoma City. We're about to start production on that record. We hope to have a radio single out with probably 1st of April. The single will go to radio. We're looking to have the record out by the end of May. And then as soon as that thing's out, man, we're going to start touring to support that record. That's why I mentioned, 200 shows a year. When you're on this actual record cycle, you want to try to tour as much as you can and get people to hear that new music and get people to buy that record and keep coming back. And that's a great way to build the band. So I think 2016 is going to be a good year for us. As far as preparing for a live performance, everybody's a little different in our band. I know Chris likes to kind of listen to some music and have a drink and get kind of worked up, and everybody has their own thing. Here of late, I guess probably the past two tours or so, maybe, I've just had like this real calmness thing that I do. I kind of just, go off by myself, put my earphones in. It's almost like a meditation kind of thing. And it's almost like I sit there and it's like the calm before the storm. I kind of get my head right, kind of get focused on what's going on. And that gives me an opportunity to kind of forget about if there's anything else going on outside the band. It gives me, 15 minutes or so to kind of, put that aside for a minute and kind of get focused on the show and doing the best show that we can. There's several songs that over the years that I've enjoyed playing live, but they do change for sure. Right now, on this past tour, Gotta Let It Die was my favorite song to play. That's been one of my favorite songs that we've ever done for a long time. We took it out of the set list for a while, but we brought it back two tours ago. I think in the fall tour, we brought it back. But it's just a fun song to play. It's on the bass part. It's really fun. It's really groovy in the middle. Before that, I really enjoyed playing Here Comes the Light, which I still enjoy playing Here Comes the Light because there's a lot of energy in that song. Enemy was a fun one to play, but it's like one day you wake up and the song is different, like your favorite song is different. Sometimes crowd reactions kind of sway your opinion on some of that. But for right now, Gotta Let It Die is probably my favorite song to play live. My favorite tour so far. We had a lot of fun with Seether last fall. That's always been one of our favorite bands. That one was good. This Hinder tour that we just wrapped was really fun. I enjoyed that a lot just because those guys, we all kind of grew up listening to the same music and our personalities clicked really well. You kind of forget about what band you're in. You just kind of are hanging out as friends. I always, always, always enjoy touring with Godsmack. Those guys go, over and beyond to take care of us, and they understand that. They've been in a situation where they haven't been treated well on tour, so they kind of took a liking to us and really made sure that we were taken care of. But Buck Cherry was a good one too. I pretty much like touring with anybody. We haven't really had any tours that I've been, really bummed about doing. It's like, I don't have a real job. I don't have I don't have to sit in an office. So I try not to get too bummed about having to tour the country and play rock and roll. So most of the tours have been pretty good. Most people that haven't heard the band, the best way I can describe what we do is, we're just regular guys with regular problems like everybody else. We just have the luxury of writing songs about them and sending them out to the world for people to hear. So a lot of times when people ask me, they've never heard the band, they ask me to describe it, I'm just like, we're a little bit of everything. Our influences are all over the board, and our records are so diverse that I'm just kind of like, there's something in there that you're going to like. Just give it a shot. If you like it, great. If not, it's not going to hurt my feelings if you don't like it. Live performances to us are very important. Like we always say, you always come see a show, you don't come hear one. So we like to put in as much energy as we can to the show, and it's almost like a give and take situation with the audience. So the audience reacts to what we do on stage, and at the same time, we react to what they do, in the crowd. So there's an energy coming, it's a two-way street coming back and forth. So we like to come in there and give them a lot of energy. Hopefully they'll give us some energy back. And plus at the same time, like we've got these songs that mean things to us. And you kind of have to put yourself in that mind frame. And, if the song's got a lot of energy, we come out of the gate with Enemy. And that's a punch in the mouth kind of song. So it just makes you want to just move to that song and rock out a little harder. It'd look really silly if we were all standing there, standing straight, knees locked, playing that song. So the show is a little bit of both. You know, it's getting into the art of the thing, but at the same time, you know, we're trying to put on a show. We're trying to get energy back from the audience as we give it back to them. So that's, you know, that's pretty much the best way I can describe how our live show is. Radio, to me, is the key to every band. Radio gets your music out to the masses, and it's always kind of a catch-22 when it comes to touring, is you can't tour without radio, but you can't have radio unless you're touring. So that's an obstacle that, as an independent band, that we've tried to climb, and it's tough. You know, we hired an independent team ourselves to go out there and pitch our radio. You know, there's only 70 active rock reporting stations in the country. And there's a lot of bands trying to get on the radio. So it's one of those things where you just have to build relationships, but you got to do whatever you need to do to get your song on the air and get spins and get on the chart, because that's what's going to take your band to the next level as far as getting on bigger tours, you know, because like Hinder knew we were worth tickets because we had a song that charted on the top 40 of active rock charts. So that's important to bands that want to bring you on a tour. They know that you've got a popular song on the radio, and you know that people that are listening to that song are going to buy tickets to the show, and that helps them out, which adds you to a tour. So in my opinion, getting airplay and support on the radio is extremely important for any band that's trying to take this job seriously. Local radio is kind of funny. You know, we had a lot of success with Here Comes the Light on the radio all over the country, except in our hometown. And I'm not sure why that was an issue. We didn't really dig into it. You know, we presented it and said, here's the song, play it if you want to play it. But whatever you can do to build a relationship with the radio, especially if you're just like a local band that's not touring yet, just even if they have like a Sunday night local show or internet radio or whatever, build those relationships with those people, and you send your music to them, it gets played. Who knows how many people are going to hear it? Who knows? Well, the one person that could hear it could be somebody that could help you that likes your band. So I think radio supporting local music is important. It's important for local bands to do whatever you can do to build those relationships with any type of radio station. The music industry now is in a place it's never been. You know, there's like, people are still stealing music. If they're not stealing it, they're streaming it. Streaming's not really paying the artist. You know, the best thing fans can do to support your local band is go buy their music or buy their t-shirts or, you know, buy the concert tickets. That's what's kind of killing the industry, is there's very little money being returned to the artist because, like I said, people are stealing music, they're streaming music, things like Spotify. It's in a funny place. I'm hoping it's going to come back around. I hope somebody can figure out a way to fix what's going on with all the stealing and the streaming and all that kind of stuff, and the music will be back to where it is, and people won't have to give up, you know, being a musician because there's no money in it. Breaking into the business for us was pretty tough. We got really lucky. We got picked up by a management company about 2010 that had some really big artists, and we spent a year with them, and we ended up, you know, having a mutual agreement to, you know, to sever ties with them. But we're still friends with them. You know, we still talk to these guys to this day, and we learned a lot about how the business works. I think that's what's very important about any local band or young band that's really is serious about this business, is do your best to educate yourself on the business. Knowing the business that you're working is extremely important to everything that you're going to do here on out. Like, if you've got the songs, you've got the show, you've got the drive, everybody in your band's on the same page, do what you can do to educate yourself on how this business works, because this business changes a lot, and you need to keep up with the changes that go through. That way you know the moves you need to make and the mistakes you need to not make. Our local music scene in Birmingham, it's different. There's not that many rock bands, original rock bands. There's a lot of cover bands in our hometown, which there's some people that just don't know that we're not a cover band. It's really strange. We've had several people at home be like, man, I knew you guys were in a band, but I had no idea you were doing all these big things. And that's kind of like, Birmingham's kind of in its own little bubble, and they don't pay that much attention to rock and roll. There's a lot of great bands. I've got friends at home that are in super awesome bands. A guy sent me, you know, some tracks last night on my phone that sits in a band, and I loved it. It's just kind of it's a different scene, you know. It's growing, though. That's what's good. Hopefully one day the scene will be back the way it was. I think in the late 90s, that had a pretty awesome scene. You know, even in the early 90s, Brother Kane came out of Birmingham. If you don't know who Brother Kane is, Google it. Look them up and go buy some of their stuff, man. Damon Johnson's been one of our mentors for a long time. New and upcoming bands that I'm into, Blower from Hinder played me a band the other night, and I have been kind of obsessed with them, been listening to them a lot, bought everything that they own, a band called Safety Suit out of Tulsa. That's really kind of what I'm into now. I do these weird shifts where I'll listen to a band, and then I'll move on to another band, I can't all take it all in at once, but Safety Suit is definitely a band that I'm into right now. Social networking is something that, it's a slippery slope, I guess. You know, Facebook's was kind of the thing. Well, it was MySpace, and then Facebook, then Twitter, and then Instagram. It's always kind of changing. It's good for the band, but I think as of late, me and Chris were talking about how Instagram, like our personal Instagram pages, have been blowing up and doing more traffic than the band is. And I think fans are really into like the personal connection with the band. Like you can go to my Instagram page and you're looking at like the things that I see, pictures that I take. It's like, kind of like in a personal experience rather than going and seeing like the band page. But the band stuff's still personal experiences too, but it's like kind of a one-on-one. Facebook's trying to monetize everything. I can't really see it lasting too much longer, but it's a good place to start. Twitter's kind of the same way. But social media definitely changed the game. And it also, I felt like it helped the industry, but I felt like it kind of hurt it because that kind of made a segue into, you know, the streaming music sites. You can find us, our website is withinreasonmusic.com. On that page, there's a little toolbar right underneath our logo that's got everything you can find, even Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. It's got a link to our Pandora station, links to iTunes, links to everything that you need to know about Within Reason. It's right there on that one site. We are using all Audio-Technica mics. We are lucky enough to work with Audio-Technica. We have a great relationship with Roxanne over there, so we use all Audio-Technica mics. Ernie Ball strings. Ernie Ball's been great to us. They hook us up with strings. I'm playing Spectre basses. PJ over at Spectre has been a buddy of mine almost 10 years now. I love those basses so much. I love playing them. I'm excited that I get to work with those guys. Another company is InTune Guitar Picks, make our picks. I don't know if you see them. I like take extreme pride in designing my guitar picks, and InTune's the company that helps us out with that. PRS Guitars is working with Jordan. I'm working, I wish I had Ampegs. If Ampegs watching, please get in touch with me. I've been playing Ampeg amps my whole life, and there's nothing to me that sounds better. I'm like that guy that drives Cadillacs his whole life. He'll always drive a Cadillac. I'll always play an Ampeg amp. Yeah, thanks for hitting me up. Like talking to you. This has been really fun. The fans, you know, keep listening to the music. We got new stuff coming. If you like it, you know, pick up some songs from us. Tell your friends about it. You know, I'm okay with you sharing the music with your friends. Keep up with us on social media, our website. Check our tour dates. We always said, you know, if you're a big fan of the New York Yankees, you always know when they're playing. So that's something that's like, check our tour dates. So we're touring a lot. So if we're coming to town, you know, come to the show, stop by our merch table after the show. We always do a signing after our set. We love to meet everybody that we can. That's our big thing. Is we want to be accessible to fans. We just want to be the band that plays, the band that leaves. You know, we'll hang out and get to know everybody. That's important to us, that we get to know everybody that's into our music. We want to meet you as much as you think you want to meet us. So I appreciate you having me. Hopefully we'll catch up with you here in the
with a man in a crimson and white. So many stars on the field, you can turn out the lights. We're number one when you play us, you better be tight. Better bring your best game to the elephant fight. We got only 60 minutes just to hold it down, cause after four quarters, we're gonna run this town. 16 championships, say it with pride. This is Alabama football, Crimson Tide. On the victory coming out of the gate. This is Saban Nation, and we're ready to play.
Bryant Denny Stadium on a Saturday night. Kittle bring a war eagle to an elephant fight. We're the best on the field, straight pound for pound. Them Alabama boys about to break you down. Grandma Jamma, yellow hammer, say it with pride. This is Alabama football, Crimson Tide.
This is Alabama football, Crimson Tide.